some of Sunny's favorite treats. It's bacon, fried up. So she's been able to smell it as I've been cooking it, and she's been anticipating training because she loves doing this. Close. Good girl. Sorry. Beep beep. Beep beep. Beep beep. Come on, up. Beep beep. So that was kind of a half step. I'm still gonna reward her before she gets bored. Close. Close. Touch. So what I just did is, she's kind of rambunctious right now. She's not really doing what I want her to do. So I'm switching to something else. Close. Good girl. Good. Get the toy. Get your dragon. Dragon. Go get it. Her dragon's her favorite toy. Get it, bud. Go get your toy. Get your toy. Oh, good girl! So terriers are not inherently retrievers. They were bred to go to ground, get animals, bring them back dead. And so they're pretty bored by it. They don't really get the gratification out of it. And my training methods differ from a lot of people's training methods, where because she's a terrier, I think it's okay for her to pull and play tug of war. It's actually one of her favorite rewards. So right now I'm teaching her pull so she can eventually help me out of my robe or my jacket. Pull. Give.
Good girl.
This is still a new trick, and I would normally have a clicker with me. So this is my foster dog. And he is blind and deaf. Came from a really bad past.
Go get it. Get it, bud.
So I try to be very dramatic, kind of like they hit the jackpot when they do something good for me. Give.
Good girl.
Grr. So I make an appropriate sound that shows her it's okay to play tug of war and to be rough. Grr.
Yay, you won!
So I like to let her know when the game's over, which is when she wins. Give. And I'm able to take it away from her, just easy. Don't have to worry about it. Wait. Go get it. So if you notice, she was able to wait for my commands and then go and get the toy.
Go get it.
Because the highest toy that she wants to get is the treat. That's her reward, I mean.
Good girl.
See if we could do something else. Walk. Ideally, she's supposed to be walking alongside me. Touch.
Good girl.
So what I find really important, and the reason why I want to start making dog training videos, is because I'm not seeing eye to eye with a lot of dog trainers. I don't think I need to shuffle my feet at her to make her move. I don't think I need one of those martingale collars, which is half chain, half knot, and yank her up when she's not doing right. Terriers were bred, the Scottish Terrier was bred to protect the homestead and to also be thrown into foxholes and to work away from direct supervision. So unlike a Labrador, unlike a Setter, unlike a Shepherd, who are always meant to look up and see what their owner or their master wanted them to do, Scotties knew that they had one mission to do, and that was either protect the home by guarding it or protect the home from vermin. So when I ask her to get a toy, I don't really care what toy she gets me. I just want her to get me something. And I feel like harsher training methods that would work on a Labrador, that they're more docile, they brush off easier, like teaching them how to sit by pushing down their bumper, anything like that, doesn't work on Scotty. Because one, they think of themselves really highly, and because they're independent thinkers, they're wondering, why are you making me do this? This is stupid. And it'll totally backfire on you. And a lot of training videos that I found on YouTube didn't have that.
Well, get it. Get the toy. Good girl! Yay!
So she dropped it halfway through.
Yay!
Which is okay with me. And because I don't have a treat to give her, I'll play tug of war. Arr! My game on sound is a fake girl.
Well done, you won!
So, I really want the world to know that the super dominant training, the really docile, light pushing around, I don't think that would work for Scotty Dog, and that there was really no market that I saw on it that was already established. So I hope this helps somebody, and I hope to make more videos talking about what I've done with her. Cheers.